is a life-changing message by the Reverend Sam Korankye Ankrah.
Matthew chapter 6, verse number 9. Matthew chapter 6, verse number 9.
Matthew 6, verse 9.
May the Lord grant your desires and your wishes. And anybody owing you this week shall not sleep until they call you tomorrow about this time and deliver into your hands what they owe you. Can you clap your hands and shout, I receive it. I can hear you shout it again and say, I receive.
Quiconque te doit cette semaine doit te payer pour que tu t'achètes un beau téléphone.
Clap your hands and say, yes.
Acclame tes mains, dis oui.
Jesus says, anytime you are praying, here is the standard of your prayer. Here is what your prayer must be marked with. Here are the ingredients. When found in your prayer, then God will answer. He said, pray after this manner. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Verse number 10. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Hear Jesus Christ. When it comes to daily bread, you pray on daily basis. Because, you guys, you haven't seen famine before. If you see famine, you see wisdom in this prayer. There has been no war. I thank God for Ghana. We haven't seen war before. So you don't see wisdom in this one. When you go to, we haven't faced drought. When you go to Ethiopia where there's drought, countries, war-torn countries, countries that are struggling over food, they pray this prayer. But God says, when you are praying, pray, give us this day our daily bread. Ours is not famine, but ours is contaminated food at the market. One family ate kokonte and granule soup. Seven family, six died. And why the seven person didn't die? Because he was late for the meal. When he came, the others had eaten and they were running. So quickly he was told that not to touch the food. Any food from the market shall not kill you. You don't know. I hear they've been sprinkling something on our tilapia, dry tilapia, Kobe, chemicals that is used in embalming dead body. Kato sali, you will not eat that kind of thing. I reduce your sugar level, your high blood pressure level. I reduce your oil intake. Any food you have been eating which is not good for your body, I cut you from it. From today, I introduce you to vegetables and fruit. The army was very weak. What will give you long life? You don't understand. Give us this day our daily bread. If you have seen war before, you will see the wisdom in that. If you have seen famine, clap your hands and say, give us this day our daily bread. Say, Lord, give us this day. You must thank God when you wake up in the morning and you have cocoa and akala. You must thank God when you have lunch. You must thank God when God gives you food. You must thank God. You must thank God. You must thank God because there are places. This is one that we raise this song. You don't sing anymore. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Nina. Hallelujah.
Anytime you sing this song, you are praying this prayer. Give us our daily bread. Oh my
dear.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. So we sing hallelujah. The Father you have breakfast means Nyamitiasi. The Father you have lunch means Nyamitiasi. The Father you are going and coming means Nyamitiasi. The Father you slept and woke up, that means Nyamitiasi. The Father you are strong means Nyamitiasi. The Father from the same market, other people eat and die, but you eat and you never die. Nyamitiasi. The Father, they poison you, but you never die. You still live. Oh my God.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
One One day I came for an all night over here. And when I got home, you know, all night you have to catch some sleep and sleep into the abnormal time, into your breakfast time. So I got home around 5 a.m. I said, okay, let me have my breakfast so I don't need to wake up. I can have enough rest. When I wake up, I can do some other things. So I went into the fridge and I was looking, and I saw this watch. Somebody said, Chewa. That day the watch was not watch, a Chewa. Some evil had gone into the watch. And the thing is in my fridge. Why should I doubt it? So quickly I put it in the microwave. Then I finish it. 3 days. Oh. Oh my dad.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
3 days.
A thing. Hallelujah.
You think I'm not worshiping? I'm worshiping God. I said 3 days.
Nous devons, la Bible déclare que donne-nous aujourd'hui notre pain quotidien. Et nous n'avons pas seulement besoin de pain quotidien, mais nous avons aussi besoin d'une nourriture saine. Nous devons prier que notre nourriture ne nous apporte pas la mort, mais nous apporte la vie.
He's a good man. I thought you were going to do this one. I would have taken my microphone from you. We must be grateful to God when we wake up and we are strong and we are healthy. We must be thankful to God when God puts food on our table. We must be thankful. Give us this day our daily bread. Okay, enough exhortation, but let's go to the main subject. And forgive us our trespasses, our debts, as we forgive those who trespass against us. 13. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. And my sermon is going to just stay on verse 13. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Other versions say, deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Le verset 13 dit, ne nous induis pas en tentation, mais délivre-nous du mal, car c'est à toi qu'appartiennent le règne, la puissance et la gloire. Ici, je veux beaucoup plus me focaliser sur ne nous induis pas en tentation.
So God says, here is the picture of what God is painting. So you are going to sleep in the night, and then when you go to bed, you say, Father, I thank you for giving me breakfast today. Thank you for giving me lunch. Thank you also for giving me supper. Now, because he said I should pray daily for my daily bread, Father, I want to commit tomorrow in advance. Father, let my breakfast be ready by the time I wake up. And also lunch. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us this day. God expects you to pray every day, every day, every day. But more than prayer and asking God for daily bread, here's what he's asking you. Anytime food is set before you, remember to say, Lord, thank you for setting some food before me. It's more than asking him for tomorrow's meal. When you thank him for tomorrow's meal, he will supply, thank him for today's meal, he will supply you for tomorrow's meal. So God is simply talking about thanksgiving and appreciation for what he has given you today. Against the backdrop of tomorrow's provision. Supernatural provision. Then it comes to praying for against sin. And so after that you say, and God also today, please forgive me for all the sins that I've committed. Today some women came and passed before me and danced in church. I didn't want to look at their buttocks, but Lord, I didn't want to look at them. Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive my sins. Lord, forgive me for uttering some words today in office and the nasty things that I said to my friend. Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me. Last month, the tithe that I was supposed to have paid, Lord, I shortcut the tithe and I took some out. Lord, forgive me. Then the next month you come again. Lord, forgive me. This month I've stolen again. Then the third month you forgive. Every month you're asking God for forgiveness. Every day you're asking God, no, it's too much. I'm going to show you how not to be asking God for forgiveness, but you stay righteous. How not to be asking God for forgiveness every day, but you are righteous. The answer is in verse number 13. Lead us not into temptation. So your prayer must not be, Lord, forgive my sins. But your prayer is, Lord, lead me not into that thing which makes me sin, for which I come back to you, always asking you for forgiveness. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil. That's the solution. That's the solution. And so, when you remember that you have to pray for your daily bread, he says, this is what you should also remember. Deliver us from evil. And I want you to know, ladies and gentlemen, sons and daughters, the one who is talking here is Jesus, the Son of God. I was doing deliverance for this woman, and the reason for the deliverance, a disaster has struck her. And the disaster was 16 years old at the time I was doing the deliverance. 16 years old. What was it? Her first daughter had died suddenly. And this is how the first daughter died. And after 16 years, she had not overcome it. Reverend. In those days, I was not called Apostle General. Reverend, I cannot sleep. Reverend. And that time I see a young girl. I said, my daughter, plus 16 years, she must be getting married. She must be a grad. The girl was such a shock academically. She was first, collecting prizes, top of her class, from class 1 to class 6. Then in class 6, when she collected the last prize, one girl walked to her. Hey, so as for you, since class 1, you've been collecting prizes, and you collect all the prizes, and we have nothing to collect. We will see how you will come back next term and come and collect more prizes. Ladies and gentlemen, when the girl went home for holidays, she woke up one day and said to the mother, "Mother, my head. They took her to hospital. She was dead. She didn't go back to JHS from one. She was gone. So who is that girl, innocent in court girl? There are agents that are set around us. They are in our classrooms. They are in our offices. Some of them we live in the same house with, and they are monitoring everything that we do. And the devil is operating evil through them. Jesus Christ says, I should tell you, when you pray, say, deliver us from evil. Because they are around you all.
Lorsque nous devons prier, et la prière que nous devons faire pour que nous ne puissions pas toujours venir à Dieu pour demander pardon, c'est de demander que Dieu nous délivre du méchant, nous délivre du malin. Lorsque nous le ferons, eh bien nous n'allons pas toujours venir à Dieu pour nous repentir,
Stand here so I don't forget about you again. Clap your hands and say, deliver us from evil. It's a powerful prophetic prayer that you must pray. 2 years ago, Pastor Nat was leading a week of the altar. And then he gave us this story. He said, about 8 years old children, they were playing. Their school is like a story, three story. And during the break time, two of the boys went up to the corner and they were playing. One of the boys heckled the other boy over the rail, and the boy fell down on the ground. His head hit the stone, and the wicked agent boy came to the class and came and sat down quietly and didn't tell anybody, as if nothing had happened. And nobody noticed the absence of the boy. I guess the mother came to the school to come and pick him, and the mother didn't find him. And the mother would have thought that, oh, sometimes he's been following the older boys home. So let me go home and check whether the older boys have brought my son home. The mother got to the house. The boy was not there. The security man in the night was going his rounds and saw somebody lying there bleeding. By the time they picked the boy, he was dead. If that boy had just said, oh, my friend has fallen over, they would have saved his life. What occurred to this small 8-year-old boy to keep this one? He's an agent. Deliver us from evil.
L'année, il y a de cela 2 ans, Pastor Nat, nous avons raconté ici une histoire deux petits enfants qui sont à l'école. Et donc, ils se sont déplacés sur les balcons. Et l'autre a poussé l'autre. Et l'autre est tombé. Mais ce petit garçon, comme il était un agent de l'ennemi, il n'a pas eu le temps de pouvoir donner l'information. C'est finalement la nuit vers 20h que l'agent de sécurité a découvert que l'enfant était déjà mort.
I'm getting angry now. Please just allow me. I'm a human being. Any evil person in your house, in your family house, in your father's house, at your workplace, anybody monitoring you with evil eyes, clap your hands and say, flash out. Oh, you are not serious like I am serious. Clap and say, flash, flash out. Say, I plead the blood against every evil in front of me, behind me, around me, whether I know them or not. By the blood, flash out. Shout yes. That's what Jesus Christ wants. You don't need to know them because you don't know them. Sometimes they are very, very, very quiet, innocent, unassuming, pretentious, kind, but evil. And a set person hiding in your life, get out! The time evil comes to us even is after we have written examination. After you have written examination, you don't know who is marking your paper. You don't know who is marking your paper. One of the fathers in the land, when he was at university, at Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, one professor said, you don't sleep. Every day, making noise, don't broadcast. I will fail you. And true, he failed him. After 4 years at Kwame Nkrumah University of Technology, came out without no certificate. Cape Coast University, another lecturer, professor, saw this guy, said, look, you people, you will not learn. I will fail you. So they wrote the paper and he was marking. When he saw the paper of that guy, he said, aha. Introduction. Then he made. Why? He was about to total the mass when his phone rang. At that time, in those days, there was no mobile phone. So it is the house one. So he got up to go landline. He got up to go and listen. After talking, he was so happy. So he came and sat down. When he came, the why at the top, he thought he had finished, and that is 77. So he circled it and said 77 B plus. The angel of the Lord is going where your enemy is. They will mark your purpose. Every wicked person, clap your hands and say, deliver us from evil.
Partout ils sont en train de se rassembler contre notre pays, contre nos maisons, contre nos familles. Nous les dispersons au nom de Jésus.
Deliver us from evil.
Délivre-nous du malin.
Oh. This is how the devil is described in the Bible. This is how the devil is described. Number one, the devil is described as a deceiver.
Le diable est décrit comme un trompeur.
He is a deceiver.
C'est un trompeur.
Always giving you counter instructions and counter word to God's holy truth.
Il te donne des arguments qui ne sont pas réels.
If the devil was not a deceiver, why did you marry the wrong person? Because when you saw him and saw her, you saw an angel of light. And you thought that this one is a gift from God, only to be deceived because there is a devil, an evil person behind. Deceiver. That's why you always go for the wrong choices.
Si le diable ne t'a pas trompé, tu n'allais pas te marier à cette personne qui est une mauvaise personne, mais la personne venait auprès de toi comme un ange.
Clap your hands and say, devil, you deceived me yesterday, but today it will not happen because my eyes are open. Devil, get off my back.
Déclare que le diable te libère parce que maintenant tes yeux sont ouverts.
Number two, the devil is described as a liar.
Le diable est aussi décrit comme un menteur.
A liar.
Un menteur.
A liar is somebody who speaks counter to the truth that you know.
Et le menteur, c'est la personne qui vient apporter le contraire de la vérité que
tu connais. That is why your bank account is zero. That is why you are poor. That is why you are sick. Because in spite of whatever God has spoken to you concerning your health, I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. I will prosper you above all things as your soul prospereth. All the promises have been negated because you hear another voice that counters the truth. It's the devil's voice you have been hearing. And his lies have brought your life to a standstill. But today God is moving you out of the camp of the enemy. Clap your hands and say, I'm coming out, I'm coming up. Let the devil hear you and say, I'm coming up. Clap your hands and say, devil, you're a liar. How many times have you not shouted this year, devil, you're a liar, but he keeps lying to you always?
Vous dites toujours que le diable c'est un menteur, mais il continue toujours à vous mentir et votre compte bancaire est toujours négatif malgré les promesses de Dieu.
The devil is also a murderer.
C'est aussi un meurtrier.
He is a murderer.
C'est un meurtrier.
Today in the first service, we were doing Thanksgiving memorial service for a 39-year-old man who had died suddenly and left his wife, widow, and one child, young child. When I see the age of the child will be about around 12 years old. And the man has just died. And I went and looked into their face and I said, Mama, don't rejoice over this death. It is not the will of God that we die prematurely when we have tasks and assignment to accomplish. Who born you and thought that you came into this world just to add to the numbers? And so that when you depart here, it doesn't matter. You are not here to add to the numbers. You are here on assignment. You are here on a mission. There is something God wants you to achieve. And until you achieve that, no death can take your life away until you are finished. Are you hearing my voice? Clap your hands and say, I will not die before my time. You have an assignment. You were born for a mission. 39 years. Nonsense.
Nous voyons des gens qui meurent à un âge très précoce, à 39 ans. Comment quelqu'un peut-il mourir à 39 ans? Tu ne mourras pas tant que tu n'as pas accompli ce que Dieu a décidé dans ta vie.
Mama Rita and I are handling a family. And the way we are struggling, suddenly the woman died, leaving three children. The first one is an adolescent child, 16, 17 years. And you know, that is the challenging time where they need a mother's love and they really need to talk to. Some things she can talk to the mother, she can't talk to the father. Die suddenly. We are struggling to keep the child, the girl, the lady in control. The father has lost control because the new mother who came in also, I don't know who sent her. We are struggling to keep the child under control. She's about 18 years. The whole family is disarray because a mother chose to die very early. Anyone who has penned you for death, and if you are desiring for death, today I change your route and I change your direction. You will not walk to the grave until you finish your assignment. If you are the one I am talking to, shout, I am the one. Let the devil hear you and shout again and say, I am the one. Let the enemy hear you and shout, I am. You know why I'm forcing you to respond? Because I'm forcing you to hate death. And I'm not keeping you alive because you are going to be poor for the next 10, 15, 20 years forever. I'm forcing you, not because you are going to live miserably for the rest of your life. No. You too, one day, you become like some Korankye Ankrah and Mama Rita. One day, you become like President Nana Akufo-Addo. One day, you become like Rebecca. One day, you become like John Mahama. One day, you become like Moses Fuamwani. One day, you become like Dangote. Oh, you are not hearing what I am saying. When I said Dangote, some of you are not responding for that. Let me tell you how he became rich. Let me tell you how he became rich. T.L. Osborne, the international evangelist, had visited Benin City to preach. crusade with Archbishop Mbensene Dahosa, one of the finest, greatest men of God who walked on this continent. Powerful man. He's going to be with the Lord. T.L. Osborne must catch a flight in Lagos to go to America for an important assignment. When they got to Benin City Airport, the flight attendant said, "Sir, the flight is full. We can't do anything." Archbishop Edausa said, "Can you open the cockpit or whatever they call, open the gate? I want to talk to the passengers." They said, "Sir, well, you can try." So they opened. Then Archbishop stood in front. He said, "Praise the Lord. I have my guest here, T.L. Osborne. He must catch a flight in Lagos and must be in America. I want one of you to vacate your seats for him. If the business you are going to do is not that important, vacate your seat." The place was quiet. And then a young man shot his hand up. And then Ida also asked him, "What do you do, young man?" He says, "I have just started business." He said, "Are you sure you don't want to go?" He said, "No, it's not important. I'm going to meet some friends in Lagos to discuss some things, and I can do that later." Then Dawsa said, "As the rains fall and they don't return, so shall your blessing be. As the rivers flow without dying and quenching, so shall your blessings flow. From today, I expand you in business. You have money, and you cannot count your money." Ladies and gentlemen, the young man who vacated his seat and gave to T.L. Osborne is Dangote.
Alpha and Omega, we worship your name. We worship your name. We worship your name, Lord. We worship Alpha and Omega. We worship your
somebody
name.
Somebody lift up your voice.
We worship
somebody
your name.
Somebody clap your hands.
We worship your
somebody
name.
Shout.
We
shout.
Alpha and Omega. We worship
Alpha and Omega.
We worship
your name.
We worship
your name. We worship
your name.
We worship
your name.
We worship.
Help is coming.
Votre secours arrive.
The devil is a deceiver. The devil is a liar. The devil is a murderer. And we know these things. And yet he's succeeding every day. Deliver us from evil. What he has killed is enough. He will kill no more. Let me try this group. What he has killed is enough. When the devil attempts your life, may the devil fail. May he be disgraced. May he be naked. May he be ashamed. Shout and tell the devil it is over.
Ce qu'il a tué, c'en est assez. Il ne tuera plus. Il ne mentira plus. Il ne va plus nous détruire.
The devil is an accuser.
C'est un accusateur.
You know what he does? The devil is the reason why your self-confidence is so low. The devil is the reason why you fail mathematics when you must not fail. The devil is the reason why you've been failing some exams which you must not fail. Self-confidence. The devil is the reason why you are a man of 38. You can't open your mouth and propose to a woman and marry. The devil.
Le diable. Il t'accuse tellement.
You don't have confidence because the devil tells you things against what the Bible has spoken about you. When God says you are beautifully made, you say, "Where is my beauty?" When God says you are more than a conqueror, you say, "Well, if I'm a conqueror, why am I so poor?"
Il te fait perdre l'estime de soi.
When God says, "I am the Lord thy God," I heal thee. You say, "God, can't you see that we have grown lean? You are listening to strange voices. You are listening to liars and deceivers and murderers and accusers." Rub your ears and say, "From today I won't listen to nonsense again." Rub your ears and say, "From today I won't listen to nonsense." Tell somebody, "From today I will hear the word of God only."
À partir de maintenant, j'écouterai que la parole de Dieu, mais je n'écouterai pas les non-sens, les insensés, les insanités.
The devil is a tempter. The devil is a destroyer. The devil is the evil one. Destroyer is the devil who destroys relationships. Is the devil who causes a father to be reckless and to be irresponsible. Is the devil that causes destruction in marriages and in businesses. The devil that destroys the success of marriages. The devil that brings academic pursuits and careers to a halt. Is the devil that cuts you away from prayer. Is the devil that destroys your Christian faith and breaks your relationship with God. Anything that you mean to do which is good, but you find something fighting you and struggling with you to destroy, it is the evil one. Deliver us from evil.
Délivre-nous du malin. Le diable, c'est lui qui détruit ta vie chrétienne. C'est lui qui détruit ton mariage. C'est lui qui détruit tes affaires. Délivre-nous du malin.
Ephesians chapter 6, verses number 11 and 12. Ephesians chapter 6, verses number 11 and 12. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11 and 12.
Ephesians 6, 11 à 12.
King James. Put on the whole armor of God that ye may be able to stand against the wiles. And I'll be doing business with the wiles of the devil. Verse number 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world or this age, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Le verset 11. C'est pourquoi mettez toute l'armure de Dieu afin de résister contre les ruses du diable. Donc j'insisterai ici sur les ruses du diable. Et le verset 12 nous dit que car nous ne luttons pas contre la chair et le sang, mais contre les principautés, contre les puissances, contre les princes de ce monde des ténèbres et les esprits méchants dans les lieux célestes.
These small two pieces of scripture brings out five revelations about the characteristics of the devil. So number one, in this piece of scripture, we see that the devil is a personality. The devil is a person. He's a personality.
Nous avons cinq caractères ici du diable. La première, c'est que le diable a une personnalité.
Number two, that the devil has a position. The devil has a position.
Deuxièmement, le diable a une position.
Number three, that the devil has power.
Il a une puissance.
Number three, that the devil has power.
Il a un pouvoir.
Number four, that the devil has a purpose.
Quatrièmement, il a un objectif.
The devil has a purpose.
Il a un objectif, un plan.
And number five, that the devil carries anointing for penetration. The devil has penetration. Now, into brackets, manipulation. That's the word. But I just want to keep all of them in peace. That's why I gave you personality, power, position, power, purpose, and penetration, into brackets, manipulation.
Le dernier point, c'est que le diable a de la manipulation. Ici, j'emploierai le mot pénétration dans tes affaires, dans ta vie.
The devil you are dealing with is not your wife. It's not your girlfriend. It's not your children. The devil you are dealing with is a person. It's a personality.
Ce n'est pas ta femme. Ce n'est pas tes enfants. Ce n'est pas ton entourage avec qui tu luttes. Mais c'est le diable qui a aussi une personnalité.
And my message to the men, as I take you to University of Ghana, Legon, I am going to, by the time I come, I will let every man know that your wife is not your enemy. Your wife is not the devil. Your children are not the enemies and they are not the devils. Stop fighting them. Stop beating them. Stop harassing them. Stop making the home uncomfortable for them. The devil is a personality. He's a spirit that has... The devil is not that physical thing that you are always fighting. He's a spirit. He's a personality. He speaks. He thinks. He moves. He calculates. He's intelligent. He is not stupid. The devil is not foolish. Jesus met a man who all his life has been bound and he lives in the tombs. And in the day he's bound with fetters and chains, he will break them. And when the spirit comes upon him, he will break them. And what he delights in doing is to take stone and he will scrape himself and scratch himself. And when the blood is coming, he starts laughing. Have you seen any normal human being that sees blood coming from his skin and is laughing before? Except he's possessed by something that tells him, kill yourself, hurt yourself, kill yourself, hurt yourself, kill yourself, hurt yourself. And then here's what the spirit will do. And the spirit, and this man saw Jesus Christ. And then he runs and says, Jesus, Son of God, true. He's the Son of God. But Jesus knew that this is not a normal human being speaking. This is something else. There's a possession in him that is speaking. And then he bowed down and he worshiped. He said, Jesus. He was worshiping. But Jesus said, liar. Deceiver. Get out of this man. Now. Let me give you an assignment. Start penning down one after the other things that you do which are not normal. Which after you come to yourself, you regret, you cry, you wish you hadn't done it. You wish you hadn't masturbated. You wish you hadn't fornicated. You wish you hadn't stolen. You wish you hadn't lied. You wish you hadn't abused that person. You wish you hadn't fought that person. You wish you hadn't... Things that you do that make you feel abnormal. That is a personality at work in your life. Now, here's the assignment I gave the first service. I said to the extent that they must ask their wives, honey, is there any observations you have made about me that makes me feel not normal? Your wife will be willing to tell you how when you get angry, you become wild. You are not a normal human being. You are possessed. It's the devil. And the day you strike your wife, fine, it's the devil who has used you. Your hands were not meant to strike your wife. Your hands are meant to worship God. The devil has taken over your hand. And the devil is using your hands to do something. Ask your wife. Your wife will tell you who you are. And I said, you should even ask your children. At first, I said, you should ask your children who are graduates and who are in the university. Then I said, no, the children are even more intelligent. Ask your children who are 8 years, 9 years, 10 years. And tell your children, what is it that you see in me that makes me abnormal? And your children will tell you, Daddy, we don't like the way you fight with mommy. We don't like it, Daddy. Daddy, we don't like it the way you scream at us. The children are only reciting my message that, Daddy, you are filled with a strange personality of the spirit of the devil. This is your prayer. Deliver me from evil, Lord. Deliver us from evil. How many times can you sit in an atmosphere like this and the Spirit of the Lord is coming to you and the Word of God is coming to you and you can't repent? Do you want to die a premature death? Can I tell you something, Daddy? When God discovers that you are destroying your wife and your children, the next thing God will do is to take you away to preserve your wife and your children. When God discovers that you are standing in his way, the next thing is to get away, get rid of you in order to save those around you. Speak gently because they are still thinking.
Ce que je voulais dire ici, c'est que si vous manifestez un comportement, que vous reconnaissez que c'est un comportement qui est anormal, que ce soit dans votre famille, et que votre femme vous le dise, vos enfants vous le disent, vous n'êtes qu'en train de répéter mon message ici. Donc vous devez demander au Seigneur de vous délivrer du tout mal, de vous délivrer du malin.
Sometimes when you go up before God, don't pray long. Just go and sing this song. You made my life so beautiful. And as you are, you have made me here. That's who you are. That's who you represent Christ on this earth. There's nothing greater. That's why I love you forevermore. You made my life so beautiful. This must be your prayer. And sometimes I can come here and I can lie here and I'll pray throughout the night. There's nothing greater than this. That's why I love you.
That's why I love you.
Forevermore. Forevermore. Then I'll pray and say, I want to be like Jesus. Come on. I want more of you. I want more of you, Jesus. The more I know you, the more I want to know you, Jesus. Oh. The scripture then. That small scripture is very loaded. For we wrestle not against the flesh and blood, but against principalities, against rulers. So the devil is a ruler. The position of the devil is a ruler. The man is, he's got authority. He has his domain where he rules, is his kingdom. When he rebelled against God, he succeeded in coming down from heaven. One third of angelic hosts. That's how powerful he is. He's a ruler. He has his own kingdom. 3, he has powers. We fight against principalities, powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world. That's the devil we are dealing with. Aren't you scared and aren't you afraid that today in Africa, Ghana, people born and bred here with the culture of this nation, a man can come home and another man is following him? Mommy, I discovered that, mommy, I'm no longer a man. You are no longer a man. What is in front of you there? This is what we call penetration, manipulation of satanic powers. The devil exercising the highest authority. Hey! Deliver us from evil. Deliver our leaders from evil. Deliver parliament from evil. Lord, don't let them pen any legislation against the word of God and against your holy word. Don't let them. Deliver us from evil. Don't keep quiet anymore, child of God. It is time for action. It is time for prayer. It is the wake up time. Your alarm clock is ringing. Don't shut the alarm clock and say you want to sleep again. You won't sleep anymore. Wake up. Deliver us from evil. Deliver America from evil. Deliver Britain, UK, and the Western world. Deliver the haters of the word of God, the haters of the gospel, the antichrist spirit, those who make mockery of the word of God. Deliver us from their hands, their powers, their rulers, their authority. Please, we wake up. We are not dealing with They control the media. They control government. They control legislative assemblies. They control the executive. They control businesses. They have money. Anytime you say something against them, they withdraw their sponsorship and they bring you to zero. Deliver us from evil. Mommy, and meanwhile, your son has beard and mustache. Mommy. Hey, Lord, deliver us from evil. Awesome God, how great. Deliver us from the social media. Deliver us from internet. Deliver us from satanic penetrations. There is a pressure on African nations, and they have been told that they must legislate and allow same-sex marriages. Otherwise, there will be no aid. Ah, is that the price and reward of poverty? And you know what annoys me? They can't go to the Emirates and tell United Arab Emirates this nonsense. They can't go to Saudi Arabia and tell them this nonsense. It is we. Give us this day our daily bread. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil. Awesome God.
Awesome God.
How great. Lord, we bow. This is, I've gone into the lamentation. This is what we call the lamentations of Jeremiah. I'm crying because as a prophet in this nation, we have worked so hard. We have preached the gospel. We have taken the young people from the streets. Today, they don't go to clubhouses anymore. We have paid school fees of young people. We have brought them Christ. They are not getting married. Solid foundation. And they are determined not to live after the order of their fathers. They want to correct the mistakes of their fathers. And look at the work we have done. And then somebody wants to send something to the parliament house. Hey! 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 Our God is able to defend himself. He will defend righteousness. And he will protect this nation. Clap your hands and say, deliver us from evil.
Under your wings.
Come on, lift up your hands and pray now.
Cover me within your mighty hand. When the oceans rise, let us
that's wrong, Jesus.
Oh, with you above the throne,
Father,
Father, you are King over the flood. Hey. I will be still and know you are God. I will be still.
Please be seated. So you don't need to go to God asking God, Lord, forgive my sins. And then to the following day you go again, Lord, forgive my sins. The same sin, forgive my sins. No, God wants you to pray and say, lead me not into temptation. So that which causes me to sin, I will not sin no more. So I don't have any confessions to make. That's the first thing. Second, how do you overcome this evil one? Three things. Number one, you need to put on the kingdom of God. Number two, the power of God. Number three, the glory of God. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. So number one, you need to take on, you need to possess, you need to wear the kingdom of God. Two, you need to receive the power of God inside of you. And number three, you need to exchange that foolishness of the devil that goes on in your head, in your heart, with the glory of God. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Vous devrez avoir en vous le royaume de Dieu. Et la deuxième des choses, c'est la puissance de Dieu. Et la troisième des choses, c'est que vous devez être rempli de la gloire de Dieu pour faire face à ces méfaits diaboliques.
So, Thursday night at the camp meeting, I'll be talking about the coming of the power of God. Because the coming of the kingdom. And then my second day, I'll be talking about the power of God. And the third night, I'll be talking about the glory, the coming glory. The coming glory. See, there is a certain level of life, spiritual life. When you are with God and you are experiencing the daily presence of His kingdom and His power and glory, people don't talk nonsense to you. They dare not come to us and tell us if we don't allow same-sex marriages, they will not give us aid. It's an insult. If you have glory, if you have kingdom power, and the presence of God is with you. Jesus Christ was teaching about the kingdom of God. He had healed a deaf and dumb mute boy. And they were talking and said, hey, he has evil spirit. He said, no, this is not evil spirit. When the house divides against itself, it cannot stand. I cannot come with evil spirit power and come and cast out evil spirit. But if this is the power of God, if this is the finger of God, then know one thing, that the kingdom of God has come upon you. The kingdom of God is a presence of God with you. When you walk, you feel the presence. When you are sleeping, you feel the presence. In your examination, you feel the presence. When people rise against you, the presence of God is there. The kingdom of God. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. When you are filled with the power of the Holy Ghost, demons fear you. Spirits fear you. Oh yeah. You don't need to announce who you are, because they themselves operate in the spirit. They know who is who. They know. When you are powerless and you are empty, everybody throws you about, everybody kicks you, everybody, you know, talks to you. How can our president go to Commonwealth? And then our presidents are sitting there, and a woman comes and says, you people, now, if you come begging, we won't give you money again. If you don't, Abba. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver President Akufo-Addo from evil. Deliver our parliament. Deliver our executive. Deliver. Deliver us from corruption. Deliver us. Jesus says we should pray that prayer. You know why? Because Jesus himself recognizes the authority and power of the evil one. The devil came to Jesus Christ and said, if you will bow down to me, see all these things, I'll give it to you. Jesus Christ, foolish, thou shalt not bow down to any other God apart from God. And Jesus rebuked him and said, get out from my face. Jesus knew him. That the man has authority, he has domain. He's a ruler. He controls. He manipulates. That word you saw, the wiles of the devil in Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 11. The Greek word is, give me the scripture. And that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. The Greek word is that you may be able to stand against the methodia of the devil, methodia. Now that's the word from which method comes, or methodology. Methodology, meaning that the devil that we are dealing with is a calculated devil. He's wise, he's a schemer, he's smart. You don't see him. Sometimes he roars like a lion, but sometimes he can also come as the light of an angel, sweet with tongues. He's a schemer. He calculates. When he's coming, you don't see him. He comes with aid, money. But in the aid, he's a killer. When you receive too much AIDS, it becomes HIV AIDS. There comes a time when we must stop your AIDS and avoid catching. Manipulative, penetrative, methodological, the wiles of the enemy, orchestrations. When he's using the media people, they don't know the devil is using them. When he's using parliament, parliament doesn't see it. Parliament sees the manipulation as human rights. Oh, if it's human rights, haven't they seen a certain man of God putting cement back on somebody's head? What has human rights said about it? Haven't they seen a certain pastor beating people in church for fornicating? That's a better thing to go and talk about. Manipulation, human rights. They were born like that. Huh. Yeah, they were born like that. They were born with inside of him. Very soon, arm robbers will say, I was born an arm robber. Please don't touch me. I don't know why I steal, but as Apostle General Kranjika has an answer, the stealing is a spirit. The devil is a personality that enters into people and uses them. I've answered for you. I've answered for armed robbers. I've answered for same sex. I've answered for thieves. I've answered for liars. I've answered. It's a personality. When you are lying, you don't even know you are lying because something is speaking through you. It's Satan. I have an answer. Come for deliverance.
Et c'est un mauvais esprit qui les possède, qui leur pousse à pouvoir agir de telle manière comme les voleurs armés pour ceux qui font le mariage du même sexe. C'est un mauvais esprit, une mauvaise personnalité qui leur pousse.
A family of three beautiful girls. I don't know what to do again. Because certainly the devil has come into the house. Who can stand against the Lord? No one can. No one will. Oh, who can stand against the King?
No one can. No one will.
Say it again. Who can stand against the Lord? Come on now.
Who can stand against the Lord?
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
No one.
Lord, release the kingdom power. Release your glory. Show us thy glory. So that our accusers and our enemies will be quiet. Oh my God, who said, Nibaya Boka Turia Neba Saya Bokeria. Sing it out.
Oh,
oh, shout,
victory belongs to Jesus.
Shout,
victory belongs to him.
Scream it out.
Oh,
scream it again.
Oh, victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him.
Lift up your hands. Who can stand against the Lord? Come on, let's go.
Who can stand against the Lord?
Shout, no one.
No one can.
Clap your hands and say, no one will.
No one will.
Who can stand against the King? Come on, let me hear your voice.
Who can stand against the King?
No one can.
No one can.
No one can.
No one will.
Shout, oh!
Oh!
Church has the victory. The people of God have the victory. Shout, shout, shout.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world.
It is our fervent prayer that this message will have an effect on your life and will lift you to the place where you belong. Royalhouse Chapel International, touching our generation with the power of God. God richly bless you.
Ancient words will guide.